Hello students, today let's start the current electricity chapter, and here a number of topics we will discuss about the effect of current, relative to current. So simple current electricity, here we will discuss the effect, the definition, the production of current, and on which factor it is depending on. All that things we will use here, and also its application we will see here. So in all of the topic of current electricity, simple the application of current we are going to study. So first of all, before starting the chapter, we have to understand what is electrical current. So electric current. So this definition you know already. So electric current is produced. First of all, how the current is produced actually. So as we know that any atom is made up of large number of electrons, large number of charge carriers are there. So if that electrons will receive energy from somewhere, then they will start to flow as the free electrons are behaving just like the gas molecules. So they are free to move, they are in moving, they are carrying some of the energy with them. So it means that due to flow of charge, some of the energy is carrying from one place to another place, and we call this phenomena as current is progressing somewhere. So simple, if you have to define electric current, so electric current is flow of current per unit flow of charge per unit time is known as electric current. So whenever a charge is flowing in 1 second, whatever charge is flowing in 1 second, that is constituted a current, and or that is carrying some energy, and due to that energy current is constituted, and this is known as electric current. And it is definition or its unit is coulomb per second, and is equivalent to ampere. So we just use the unit to measure the electric current, that is ampere as the unit, after the name of the scientist ampere. We are using it in honor of him. And also you know that already electric current is a fundamental unit here, or ampere is a fundamental unit. So this is also fundamental quantity, base quantity that we know. Its value or can be defined by Q by T. So if you have to define 1 ampere, so 1 ampere is that value of charge that is flowing in 1 second. So this is known as, or 1 ampere is the time taken to flow by 1 coulomb charge is 1 second. So in unit time, the 1 coulomb charge, flow of 1 coulomb charge is known as 1 ampere. So in any way you can define it simply. If you will put the value of T is equal to 1 second, then 1 ampere will be equal to 1 coulomb charge. Obviously, the thing is, this 1 coulomb charge, if it is flowing in 1 second, that is known as 1 ampere current. Next factor here, what is conventional current and what is electronic current? So there are two names that will appear always in your chapter, that is conventional and electronic current. So conventional current is particular the direction of current in which we are just taking, or we are seeing the current direction. So the direction of current as it is given by the electric field lines concept. Like we know that in the concept of electric field lines, electric field flows from, or electric field lines started from positive charge and it ended to negative charge. It was given by the Benjamin Franklin, you know that. And that time as negative charges were not discovered, so we have just given the direction of field lines from positive to negative that time, and that is also we are continuing that actually. So it means if electric field direction is from positive to negative, then conventional current direction should also be from positive to negative. So it means that the flow direction of flow of positive charge is taken as the direction of conventional current. So if we have to see what is direction of conventional current, then this is the flow of direction of positive charges. First, flow of positive charge is known as conventional current, and electronic current, if you will see that. So electronic current means the current constituted by the electrons. So as we know that electrons are negatively charged particles, so it means that negative, if electron will receive, its direction will be opposite to the direction of positive charge. So this is electronic charge current, this is conventional current. simple, you don't have to be confused. The direction of electric current will be always in the direction of positive charge carriers, or you can say that this is opposite to the negative charge carrier. So if you you are able to see the direction of electrons, then its opposite direction will be the direction of conventional current. Next topic that we have is Ohm's law. This is also very important topic, and I think we have even discussed already it in our I think previous classes. So Ohm's law actually is an experiment about the change in potential with the change in current. So Ohm actually designed a circuit, and that circuit was particularly, he was trying to see the effect of current on effect of voltage. So he just see that whenever current in any circuit that is changed, then due to change in current, potential is also changing. Up to now we have understood only that if charge is changed, then due to change in charge, potential was changing. But here we are seeing that if current is changing, then with change in current, potential is changing. So this was the new thing that Ohm has detected with his circuit there. But it is not actually new thing. If you will see, if anywhere flow of current charges are changing, number of charges are changing. So if number of charge will change, then according to that, flow of charge will also change. And if flow of charge is changing, then current will change. So it means that if current is changing, then according to that, voltage will also change. And he saw that they are linearly changing if some of the conditions are fulfilled there. First condition is that the temperature should be constant. Reason is that this current is depending on the temperature. So whenever temperature will increase, you know that due to the breakage of covalent bond or due to the supply of external energy, some of the covalent bonds will break from the atoms, and due to that, number of charge carrier or number of electrons will increase. So if charge carrier will increase, then due to that, current will increase also. So due to change in temperature, change in electric field will be there. So it means that temperature should be constant if we are seeing this linear relationship. Second concept, if some of the physical conditions, so the physical properties means like the potential that we the systems that we are using, that should not be changed, like the length of wire and whatever we are using, that is not changing. If then that time the potential difference between the plates, that is directly proportional to the change in current there. And if we will just remove the proportionality here, and constant will be appear here, that is equal to the, let's suppose this is constant is R, and this R constant is known as the resistance of the circuit here. So it's by graphical method we will see. Suppose on this we have taken I, on this we have taken D, then its graph is linear. The slope of this graph represent the value of this R. So R is the slope of the graph of this V and I characteristic. So, and this is known as resistance of the circuit. So simple, resistance is defined as the change in potential by the unit change in current is known as its resistance. So from here, if you will see, if there is greater change in current here, then there will be the greater change in less change in resistance. Due to that, if there is greater change in potential. But if suppose resistance is very large and current is also large for that value, so it means that potential will be less there. So simple, this property represent the resistance or in the path of, or any kind of opposition in the path of the flow of current. So from here, if the flow of current is greater, then its value will be small. But if its value is greater, then flow of current will be small there. So it is an kind of opposition in the flow of current. Due to the large value of resistance, always the flow of current that will be small here. So this is known as the resistance, which is just like we having just like we have understood in last year existing pores or dissipating pores in the terms of damped harmonic oscillation. So number of damping pores we have, this is just like the same thing. Here resistance is just behaving like that damping pores that was damping the simple harmonic oscillation. So this resistance is just opposing any kind of flow in the current, and if its value is greater there. So if we want a greater value of current, then we should keep always, or we should use such kind of material for which resistance is small. So here in current electricity, we will also see the variation in resistance, or we'll see in what factor we can just change the resistance here, and also to change the resistance in which combinations we can just combine it, like the capacitors we have understood before. And also earlier the symbol is given by this. This is the symbol of resistance, and if we will just use this arrow here, so this represents the variable resistor. So two kind of resistors we have. Resistor is an instrument which has the property of resistance, and it is represented by first like this way, and this one we will use when resistance is constant, and this one we will use if there is the range in the resistance, means resistance have some value to some value, so that time we will use it. Next thing, on which factor resistance is depending on. So first factor that affect the value of resistance, that is length. So it is all the things that we will discuss here. This is experimental result. So it has seen that whenever length of the wire is increased, then due to increase in length of the wire, resistance of the circuit is increasing. So it means that from this concept, if we will summarize it in one word, so this value, first point is R is directly proportional to L. Means change in length, there will be change in resistance of the circuit. One more thing, actually, if you want to understand the resistance concept, then you can understand it by the motion of electrons also. Like in any system, suppose we are talking about the conductor. So in conductor, there are a large number of electrons we have. And that large number of electrons that are moving randomly, if a very large amount of electric field is not present anywhere. So if, as I just told you, electrons or free electrons, they are just behaving like the gas, they are following the properties of the gas, then we know that gases, molecules are behaving, they are moving randomly, they are moving in zigzag motion, or they are doing Brownian motion. So it means that electrons will also do the Brownian motion here. So due to their zigzag motion, due to their Brownian motion, they will like if number of electrons we have. So this electron is moving, and obviously if it will reach here, due to collision, it will again reach here, this will be here. We'll see, if you will see here, no any fixed direction of electron here. So this type of motion is known as zigzag or Brownian motion. So electrons are also moving in such a way. It means that if they are moving randomly, then they will collide with each other. And if they will collide with each other, then there should not be means there will not be any direction of the current or direction of charges that are moving. So if charges are moving in a particular direction, then that time current is flowing smoothly. But if there is a resistance or there is a blockage due to collision of electrons that is appearing somewhere, then charges will not flow. It means that they are just blocking the flow of charge, and you know that whenever flow of charge will decrease, then current will also decrease there, and due to decrease in current, obviously resistance will change there. So by the formula, R is equal to V by I. So if current is decreasing, it means that resistance is increasing there. So whenever length of the wire that is long, so due to long length of the wire, electron will collide more, and due to the more collision, obviously resistance will increase there. So first factor that is here, that is affecting the resistance of any wire, that is its length. So if length we are increasing, then resistance is increased also. So that's why we have to keep our resistance is smaller, then we just try to take a small length wire always. And if we have to increase it, then that time we increase the length of the wire there. Second concept on which it is depending, that is area of the wire that we are taking. or area of any conductor that we are taking. So suppose the conductor that we have taken, its area is A, then it has been seen that this R is inversely proportional to the area of the conductor. Now reason is that if area will increase, then due to increase in area, this collision will be small. You can understand this concept by the same thing, like large number of people are moving in crowd, and there is the road that is very narrow. So in narrow road, they will start to collide with each other. But if the road is very broader, then that time, or wider road is there, then that time they will not collide and they will move smoothly. Means the flow of or motion of that person, that will be smooth. So in the same way, electron will behave like just like the same. Means area we are increasing, then due to increasing area, flow is increasing. So if flow will increase, then current will increase, and due to increasing current, resistance will decrease there. So that's why resistance is inversely proportional to the area or change in area of the conductor here. Third property on which it is depending, that is nature of the material. So whenever we are changing the conductor or that material we are using, then that time its conductivity also changes. So reason is very simple, that if we will change the conductor, then every conductor has different number of electrons. They have different conducting properties. So obviously due to their change in property, flow of charges will change. Flow of charge will change, flow of current will change, and due to that resistance will change also. So if we will summarize these two results here, so this due to these two results, R will be directly proportional to L upon A, or R is equal to proportionality constant, that is rho. So here rho is a proportionality constant, and it is known as resistivity of the material. So here a new term that is arises, it is also known as specific resistance. It has two value, name, you can call it by any one name, that is electrical, specific resistance, and second one, resistivity of the material. So it means that whenever material will change, according to that, this value of resistivity will change, and that time value of R will change also. Now let's see what is the resistivity or specific resistance exactly. So definition then is very easy. Definition you can just see by yourself by multiplying this term. Means if you have to see what is the value of rho, so this is equal to R A upon L. So by keeping the length of the conductor by 1 meter, and by keeping its area is 1 meter, the resistance is known as its resistivity. Simple. The resistance of resistance of a cube of 1 meter length or unit length is known as its resistivity. Is very simple. Means if 1 meter cube or 1 centimeter, 1 meter length we are using for any cube, then that time obviously its length is 1, its area is 1. This will be cancelled out, then its resistance will be equal to its resistivity. So that is, I think, very clear. Next factor is that this value, this the term that is resistivity or specific resistance, what is this? Actually, resistance is changing with change in other quantities, but this resistance will change even for a single conductor. Means in the same conductor, if the value of some of the factors are changing, then due to that obviously its resistance will change also, but its resistivity will not change. Actually, resistivity is the property of the medium. Resistance is not the property of medium. It is changing even for a single medium, but resistivity only changes when there is a change in medium. So it is the nature of medium, it is a fundamental thing. Resistance is not the fundamental concept. Resistivity is the fundamental concept. Means if we have to understand the concept of resistance of any kind of material, then first of all we have to keep the knowledge of the resistivity for this. You can understand it by the example. Suppose any conductor that has length 20 centimeter and that has length also. These two conductor or two copper wire we have just taken. One has length 20 centimeter, one has length 10 centimeter. then if we will find the resistivity of this one, then resistivity for both of the wires that will be same, because the material is same here, but resistance for both of the wire will change that time. So simple resistances are change even for the single same material, but resistivity is not changing. It means that it is the fundamental nature of the system, nature of the material, that represent how much resistance any system can provide in the flow of the charge or in the path of the charge anywhere. So next factor that we will discuss, that is current density. Here first of all, small factors that we need to understand for the flow of current or for the application of current. Let's see that. So your next factor is current density. So current density is defined as the amount of charge flowing per second per unit area normal to the flow of charge. So it means that if you have to define current densities, then it is just written by some J. So it is given by current flowing per unit area per unit time. So this is known as its current density. So for unit time, we can define the current density simple by I by A. So simple, in 1 second or in unit area, what is the current flow of current normal to the flow is known as its current density. It is the vector quantity, and it also represent the direction of current, and also how much current is flowing in unit area in unit second. It is representing that thing. Next factor, or it's a unit, if you will see, then its unit is ampere per meter square. The reason here I just told you, in 1 second we are taking it. So simple, current flowing per unit area per second we are talking here. So per second, for that, if you will see the, it's a simply unit, then that will be equal to ampere per meter square. Next topic is conductance or conductivity. So conductivity, as it is the property that is showing, there is very easily the flow of electron we are getting. So it means that if flow of electron is easily we are getting, then there should be the increase of flow of charge. So it is just like the opposite property of the resistance. As resistance is opposition to the flow of charge, but conductivity is freedom for the flow of charge, so, or support in the flow of charge. So simple, conductivity is defined in terms of resistance as it is the reciprocal of the resistance. So if we have to define conductivity, so this is the reciprocal of the resistance. So if we have to find out conductivity of any material, yeah, then if we know resistance of that material, then we can find out what will be the flow of current in that, and even we can compare it for the different length, we can compare it for different material easily with the help of the knowledge of resistance here. So if we need greater conductivity material, then we can choose by comparing them easily. So conductance is, I think, now clear. Conductivity, actually, conductivity is the property, like it is just like the same thing, like we have resistance and resistivity. So resistance was the nature through which it is opposing the flow of current. So conductance was, is nature through which it is supporting the flow, or it is showing how much charges are flowing with the time. So, and conductivity is the property of the material that is showing material is conducting or not, means material has the properties of conductance or not. So if any material that has greater conductivity, suppose we have four material and we have just defined or we have calculated conductance of that four material. So if the greater conductance, we can say that its conductivity is greater, means that material is capable to for the greater flow of current in comparison to all other. So it is also the properties of material that allow us to understand if we need a greater flow of current, then which kind of material we have to choose. So we will always choose that material whose conductivity is greater and whose resistivity is smaller. So it means that conductivity is reciprocal of resistivity, while conductance is reciprocal of the resistance. So this is conductance, and conductivity, let's suppose we are just defining it by sigma. So this is given by 1 upon rho here. So this is reciprocal of resistivity, this is reciprocal of resistance. This is conductance, this is conductivity. So these are very basic topic, very basic difference here. Next thing, like vector form of Ohm's law. How can we write Ohm's law in any vector form? Let's see that. So as Ohm's law, we know already here, V is equal to, suppose we have any conductor that has length L, that has electric field E due to charges and potential V, then we can write E is equal to E into L by the relationship between E and V, that is E equal to V by R. So here the R is equal to L we have, so we can write down this value here. Next thing, by Ohm's law we can write V is equal to I R. And obviously, by the definition of R, we can write here, or by the effect problems on R, we can write it. This is rho L upon A here. So this is equal to this value, and also this value is equal to E into L. This is the same thing. Same potential is generated. So L will be cancelled out from here. This will be E into A. This is I into rho here. L will be cancelled out. E into A is equal to I into rho. Now, if you will see current density, then current density is given by current per unit area here. So, as current per unit area, we can just calculate from here. This will be E is equal to I by K into rho from here. This is equal to J into rho here, and J, we know that this is vector quantity, this is also vector quantity. So the vector form we can write J is equal to E by rho. So this is the vector form of Ohm's law here, that just relate the two terms, that is current density and electric field produced inside the conductor. Or as we know that 1 by rho is equal to sigma, that is conductivity. So we can write J is equal to sigma E. So this is the basic form of vector form of the Ohm's law here in the terms of conductivity, electric field and current density. So by using this concept, we can easily understand what is the current density, or we can even calculate the conductivity easily if we know current density and electric field here. So I think the vector form of Ohm's law, that is now clear. Now next topic is how can we classify the material based on the conductivity property or resistivity. Earlier I have told you already, we can classify material based on free electron model and number of free electrons. We have categorized that already before in topics. But we can also categorize them by using the property of conductivity or resistivity. So as in case of conductor, there are a large number of electrons present. So due to large number of charge carrier, flow of current is easy there. So if easily current is flowing there, it means that conductivity is very high. So conductors are those material whose conductivity is high. And if conductivity is high, then we know that conductivity is reciprocal of resistivity. So it means that its resistivity is very small. Next thing, if we have to define insulator, then as we know that insulators are those material in which very few amount of charge carriers we have. So if we will see charge carriers, then if the number of charge carrier is very few, it means that flow of current will be very small. So if flow of current is small, it means that the resistance in the path is very large, or conductivity is very small. Simple, if flow of current is small, conductivity is small. And if conductivity is small, then resistivity is high. So we can define insulator in terms of conductivity or resistivity. These are those material for which conductivity is very less, but resistivity is very high. While conductor for those material that for which conductivity is very high and resistivity is very low. There is a new kind of material also, later we will discuss that in semiconductor devices, that is semiconductor material. So these are the material that conductivity lies between conductor and insulator. means its conductivity is greater than insulator, but it is less than conductors. Means only small conduction is possible there, and its resistivity is also between the values of resistivity of insulator and conductor there. So basically, by the help of the topic that we have discussed, we can categorize material, we can understand material, we can just know the properties of material, and after that we can design any circuit. Later I will tell you that things. So for today, I think students, whatever we have not discussed, that is clear. So just end the class here. In next class, we will discuss rest of the things, or we will first discuss about the resistors from tomorrow. Number of topics we have discussed for the resistors. So let's start them from tomorrow. I think the basic topic about the current electricity, that is clear.